بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الحمد لله رب العالمين وصلى الله وسلم على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم أما بعد أيها الأحبة في الله continue on in our study or reading of Shaykh Rabee' bin Hadi Al-Madkhali Hafidhullah Ta'ala his treatise entitled Encouraging Harmony and Wisdom in Dawa and Warning from Discord. The Shaykh was talking about the importance of Ahl Ilm and having Ilm and Fiqh and Basira in Dawa, that there should be wisdom and there should be knowledge before speaking. As Imam Al-Bukhari Rahimahullah Ta'ala said, he entitled a chapter in Sahih Al-Bukhari entitled Bab Al-Ilm Qabla Al-Qawli Wal-Amal, the chapter of knowledge precedes speaking and actions, letting us know that we need ilm in our dawah. That's the only way you can have true wisdom and true fiqh. True fiqh is fiqh fi deen, is understanding of the religion. As the Prophet ﷺ said, مَنْ يُرِدَ اللَّهُ بِهِ خَيْرًا يُفَقُّ فِي الدِّينِ. Whenever Allah wants good for a person, He gives him understanding of the religion. And another very important reason for this knowledge, as the Shaykh already mentioned, is because this knowledge brings about taqwa and God-fearfulness. So the more a person really knows, we're not just saying they memorize, they know those ayats, they know those ahadith, they know those statements of the Salaf. That's something different. But the more they really know that Allah Azza wa Jal is watching them, and they act upon that, then this is taqwa Allah Azza wa Jal, and this is real ilm. As the Salaf used to say, Al-amal thamarat al-ilm, or kama qal, that the fruit, the fruit of knowledge is deeds, is actions. So true taqwa Allah Azza wa Jal, it comes from knowing Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is watching you. Not just having the knowledge that you memorize the kitab, and you memorize something from the sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, but you don't act upon it, because then you don't have real ilm, because you're not really practicing. That's not true ilm, because the thamarat al-ilm, the fruits of knowledge, is deeds, is good deeds. It should encourage you to be a better Muslim, to practice better, to have better manners with your brothers and sisters, to fear Allah, stay away from His prohibitions in doing His commandments. That's why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in Kitab al-Kareem, إِنَّمَا يَخْشَى اللَّهِ مِنْ عِبَادِهِ الْعُلَمَاءِ, that only those who fear Allah from amongst His servants are those who have knowledge. It's the ulama. And we're talking about the ulama, ulama rabbaniyun, those ulama that practice what they preach, and they raise the people in stages. They don't start with major masail. I'm going to teach you this science and that science. I'm going to teach you, you know, in-depth knowledge of the ulum hadith, you know, the sciences of hadith. Let's get deep into that, and you don't know tawheed. Or let's start you off with jar wa ta'dil. Let's start you talking about this one and talking about this one. You need to learn about criticizing individuals, and you don't know about tawheed. That's not what the ulama rabbaniyun, that's not what they teach. And that's not what you see our ulama, ulama Ahl Sunnah teaching. So this is advice to the du'at, to follow that madhab and that minhaj. Don't busy the people with only refutations, and you haven't raised them up. You don't. They don't know the fiqh of salat. And I've heard about this countless times from brothers who are in positions of dawah in America, in the UK, saying, we went to such and such community, and it was supposedly a Salafi community, ala kitab wa sunnah, and the understanding of the Salaf. And they knew about Abu Hassan Ma'rabi, and they knew about this one, how he deviated. and they knew about Yasser Qadi amongst the Americans, and they knew about this one in the UK, and they knew about this one in France, and they knew so-and-so was off it, and they knew the Khilafat Bain al-Ulama. They knew that. They were aware of those things. But hardly any of them came to the prayer, and hardly any of them knew the fiqh of Salat, or even fiqh of Tahara. And these are true, this is real. This is not to put anyone, to criticize anyone, but it's to wake us up to problems that we have within our community that we have to rectify. We have to come back to true ilm, and the thamarat ilm to practice. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentions also the fadl of Ahl ilm, as the Shaykh also put in his treatise. يَرْفَعَ اللَّهُ الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا مِنْكُمْ وَالَّذِينَ أُوتُوا الْعِلْمَ دَرَجَاتٍ وَالَّذِينَ أُوتُوا الْعِلْمَ دَرَجَاتٍ Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, في كتابه الكريم, Allah will raise those who have believed amongst you and those who were given knowledge by degrees. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala raises the people of knowledge. So it's not about being famous, being popular in such and such circle and such da'wah circle, and you make da'wah and all. This is beautiful if you're doing it for Allah and you're spreading Allah's deen. Walhamdulillah, hadha ni'ma azeem that Allah has given certain people, and they're famous in spreading khair. Then this is excellent. This is a ni'ma. And that's Allah raising them up. But the goal is not fame. The goal is that Allah raises you in your practice. Raises you by giving you, of course, the blessings in the hereafter, in this life as well as the hereafter. But Allah raises you. See the ulama, those who were given ilm, you see how Allah has favored them and raised them to where some, they can just serve this religion. They don't have to do things outside of their field, but they can focus on teaching kitab wa sunnah. That's Allah raising them up, because He wants good for them. مَنْ يُرِدَ اللَّهُ بِهِ خَيْرًا يَفَقْهُ فِي الدِّينِ Whenever Allah wants good for a person, gives them understanding of the religion. كَمَا قَالَ النَّبِي صَلَى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمْ Then the Shaykh said, أَحَبَّتِ فِي اللَّهِ So be keen of being from amongst these people, meaning that you combine knowledge with actions, that you act upon the knowledge that you have. This is the fruit of knowledge, Allahu Akbar. Even I didn't review this, but this is exactly what the Shaykh is saying. Talking about, he's giving you those, a paraphrase of the Nas, of those statements of the Salaf. Showing that he's on Kitab wa Sunnah, and the understanding of the Salaf, bi-idhnillah ta'ala. So he says, you be keen of being from amongst these people, meaning that you combine knowledge with actions, that you act upon the knowledge that you have. This is of the fruit, this is the fruit of knowledge. And the fruit of having taqwa of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So it is upon you, O brothers, to be in true, remain, that is sincerely for the sake of Allah, and to gain beneficial knowledge and to have pious actions. So it's upon us to practice what we understand of the religion to the extent of our ability, and to continue to gain knowledge so that way we may fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That's why we need to gain knowledge. As the Prophet ﷺ said in a very long hadith, قَالَ إِنَّ الْأَوَّلَ النَّاسِ يُقْضَ عَلَيْهِ يَوْمَ الْقِيَامَةِ رَجْلٌ أُسْتُشْهِدَ إِلَىٰ آخِرَ حَدِيثِ The Prophet ﷺ said, the first people on the day of judgment who will be judged is a man who was martyred. And then the second person was a person who was a person of knowledge, an alim, and a scholar, and a reader of the Quran, reciter of the Quran. And the third one was a person who spent all of his wealth, supposedly in the cause of Allah, doing good. But their intention was not to please Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That's the shahid. The point of mentioning this is that this illustrates for us that we have to have sincerity to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That it's about action. It's about practicing what we know and understand. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in Kitab al-Kareem, وَالْعَصْرِ إِنَّ الْإِنسَانَ لَفِي خُسْرٍ إِلَّا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا وَعَمِلُوا الصَّالِحَاتِ وَتَوَاصَوْا بِالْحَقِّ وَتَوَاصَوْا بِالصَّبْرِ By the time, indeed, mankind is a loss, except for those who have believed and done righteous deeds and advise each other to truth and advise each other to patience. True iman can only be built upon knowledge, and pious deeds can only be derived from knowledge. And only those who have knowledge are to give dawah to Allah. Being patient from harm is something that is required from one who has knowledge and teaches it and gives dawah to it. So be from amongst those who have knowledge and truly believe in this knowledge and call to it, as well as call to iman. And are patient when being harmed while calling to Allah tabarak wa ta'ala, while they are calling the people to this goodness and trying to make this knowledge reach them. Allahu Akbar. Allahu Akbar. And we ask Allah the Almighty to accept our good and forgive our evil. Anything I said that was correct was from Allah Azza wa Jal. Anything I said that was incorrect was from myself and the shaitan. Wa sallallahu wa sallam ala nabiyyina Muhammad wa ala alihi wa sahbihi wa sallam.